for unconditional love. I tell them to look at your fiance. Turn around. Look at him. Look him in the eye. Look him up and down. And tell me this. If he or she never changes one bit, will you still love them? Will you still want to be married to them? If they never change, because you know who they are right now. If they messy, they're probably going to stay messy. It's true. I still leave my socks on the floor. I promised Deion when he got mad I'm married, I was going to do better. I'm doing better. One that says no to that question. Wedding's off. Session suspended. Call me when you're ready to accept him or her just as they are. Why do I do that? I do that because I know that the love you need to stay married is more than a feeling. It is an unconditional love. The mistake that some couples make when they decide to get married is the mistake of thinking that they will change him or her. They will change the
Talking point number one calls for selective communication. Talking point number two calls for constructive communication. And finally, talking point number three. Building healthy relationships requires beneficial communication. Beneficial communication. Walk the text with me. The writer concludes the verse with these words, that it being your communication, may benefit those who listen. Alright, so the words that come out of your mouth are supposed to benefit those who, the communication that comes out of your mouth is supposed